A study was done by a consulting firm, which found that software engineering projects that were developed using agile methodologies had a 268% higher failure rate than those that do not. Now, this study is probably biased. They surveyed 600 software engineers from the UK and the US. And it does seem like businesses love agile. But software engineers, the actual workforce that has to implement agile, software engineers hate what agile has become. Agile is a development methodology that focuses on two main areas. The idea of doing projects in small continuous cycles rather than one big cycle. And it needs to follow the Agile Manifesto, which can be seen here. And look, if you actually read the manifesto and the definition of Agile, it's good. That's not the problem. The problem is that businesses have come in and they have followed the principles blindly without any project context and have basically destroyed Agile. Nowadays, Agile is practiced like this. Devs get a list of tasks that they need to complete within 2 weeks, also known as a sprint. Objective one is to get the product out to the customer as quick as possible. And objective two is to communicate continuously and consistently. And I think that is problem number one. So in an agile environment, if you are following Scrum, which is a framework of agile, you have a few meetings. You'll have a sprint planning meeting, which happens before your 2 week sprint. Then you have daily stand-ups or scrums every day. Then after the 2 week sprint is complete, you have a sprint review to discuss the completed items that you've done. You also have a sprint retrospective. This is where you reflect on the past 2 weeks. You have something called backlog grooming, which is where you review the backlog. And there's a whole bunch of other meetings too. You have presentations, demos, one-on-one meetings, company meetings. There is a lot of communication. And are all of these meetings actually mentioned in the initial manifesto? No. In fact, this is the only thing the manifesto mentions. At regular intervals, the team reflects on how to become more effective, then tunes and adjusts its behavior accordingly. This was on the subreddit Experienced Devs. Since switching to Scrum, my entire days are nothing but meetings. This is my fifth company I have done Scrum with, so I'm pretty familiar with it. However, since switching to Scrum, the entire department has experienced one huge problem. All we do is go to meetings. Our daily stand-ups are 15 minutes, which is great. But then we have grooming for 1.5 hours, sprint planning for 1.5 hours, long retros, demos, process meetings, values meetings, side discussions meetings, PM meetings, one-on-one department meetings, and all company meetings. For reference, prior to Scrum, I had 3 hours of meetings a week. Now I average 13 hours of meetings a week. Again, I don't think agile here is the problem, but how companies actually interpret agile. And interestingly, in this thread, a lot of developers have agreed and said, yes, they have worked in an environment that has done the exact same thing. This person responded, just left a job that was like that. Safe agile, that's another framework. What a farce. Literally 60% of sprints are spent in pointless ceremonies. Great username there as well. But often, one of the major complaints with Agile is there are too many meetings. Like with this post, it says, team rebels against too many meetings. What can I do? Someone responded, too many meetings usually means too many meetings. It means that meetings aren't effective. Figure out why they don't think meetings are effective. Which I agree, if meetings aren't effective or nobody's learning anything new from it, why bother having it? And the issue here is that often developers will bring this up. This is a conversation that I've been part of a lot of times. They will bring up the issues of having too many meetings to the Scrum Master or Project Manager. And often the Scrum Master or the Project Manager will shut it down and say, sorry, that's agile, that's the framework. Which leads me to my next point of discussion. So this Reddit thread is titled, since switching to Scrum, my entire days are nothing but meetings. And someone asked OP, what would happen if you decline the meetings? If you aren't getting or contributing value, just don't go. And the response from OP was the following. I actually brought this up in the retro. The people on the team were very supportive of the idea. However, the engineering manager, they attend all our meetings, and the Scrum Master were very much against the idea. So needless to say, I haven't seen anyone decline a meeting. And yes, you can be vocal about it and decline your meetings. Project managers just don't seem to listen. The project managers or scrum masters of Agile, that role is so interesting to me. And please let me know your opinion on what I'm about to say, because I've always thought this, but I was so scared of voicing it because I obviously don't want to hurt the project managers or scrum masters. But the way that role is set up, it feels like they're planted by leadership to be spies. I feel crazy for saying that, and I obviously don't think that, but it feels like that. It just feels like they are imposters. Just the way that they interact and the role that they need to do, it just feels like they are never part of the team. Like they're just meant to go and tattletale to the bosses. The other thing as well is that a lot of them aren't actually developers with experience. So it is hard for you to get actual help from them when it comes to creating tasks, chatting about deadlines, because it almost feels like they don't know what's going on and all they do is care about updating their Jira. And don't get me wrong, I've known some amazing project managers, but most of the time, the amazing project managers are often really experienced developers, which is another issue, right? Because the pool of experienced developers are small, and then the pool of experienced developers who actually want and enjoy project management is even smaller. This Medium article titled Good Scrum Master, Bad Scrum Master puts it nicely. And the person who wrote it is actually an Agile coach. Good Scrum Masters care for people. Bad Scrum Masters focus on numbers. He goes on to say, they try to get the team to estimate and plan everything as detailed as possible to create accuracy and optimize velocity. But this approach doesn't pay off because in the end, you have an optimized feature factory and an unhappy zombie scrum team with stressed out team members. This was a popular thread on Reddit where a lot of developers actually expressed their frustrations with project managers. Anyone else getting taken over by project managers and feel all is lost? The poster says that their company has hired a new project manager, and they go on to say this. This person came from a company of 340,000 employees to our little company of 800 employees, spent a few weeks reconfiguring Jira and basically put a microscope on all the development teams. She and her direct report, the Scrum Master, are both old school enterprise IT PMs that went out and got a Scrum/Agile certs to stay relevant in the job market and seem to have no trust or respect for software development, possibly because they really don't understand it. And the responses below were pretty sad. They were concerning. One developer said, I've been through these types of reorgs twice. You have no say whatsoever. You either get in line and play the game or get another job. Fighting this will brand you as hard to work with and they will out you. Harsh reality, but the straightforward truth. And the response to that was, second that, I am 100% on same situation as OP, and I believe Scrum Masters are the herpes of software engineering. I try to keep this channel PG because I'm a small channel and I'm trying to grow. And I think the algorithm doesn't like adult things, but some posts on Reddit are just too good to censor. In the same thread, another dev responded, I am in a similar situation. In my 10 years of experience, I never felt like I was burning out. But with this new management style, I am being harassed every day to finish my tasks quicker. And I feel burnt out. My life feels like it revolves around sprints, and the life restarts every first day of the sprint. And there were so many responses of people saying, I'm in the same boat as you. So what do we as software engineers do? I don't really have a way forward with this. I can't say, if your company is using Agile and it doesn't work, speak up, because the job market is terrible. So if you do something like that, or if you push back, often you're branded as a developer who is hard to work with and not agile and not fitting the core principle values of the company. And when it comes to layoffs, you're first on the list. And is that fight really worth fighting for? And sure, I'm sure there are other frameworks that work better, but agile done right is fine most of the time. This post is titled Client Runs on Waterfall. Waterfall is another project management framework where each phase must be complete before the next phase actually starts, with little to no overlap or iteration. And your phases are generally much larger than agile. Waterfall is older and it does have some issues, but this dev is actually loving it. They say, I'm secretly loving it. This is the first contract where I'm not rushing around every sprint trying to piece together half-baked features and pushing them out the door. Everything is regularly tested and documented. Nothing gets released until all requirements are met. No sprints. We celebrate every release. Client gives feedback. Someone responded with such a good one-liner. They said, waterfall done well is better than agile done poorly. And the entire issue is that agile is done poorly a lot. Not that agile is a bad methodology. Someone also said, you're just describing how an agile process is meant to be. True waterfall is designing the system upfront. Agile is doing it feature by feature and having small releases. Scrum gets a lot of hype, but sprints and other Scrum peculiarities are not what agile is about. So is it time to move on from agile? New agile, definitely. If someone could come up and market an Agile 2.0 that actually puts the developers and the development process first and not the company or the customers, that might be a way better option. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, please like and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.